Rutger Steenbergen here with a video about organizing plugins in FL Studio. You can add plugins, VST instruments in different ways in FL Studio. One of the ways is with this plus sign. When you click on it, you can select the plugin, but you can select it from the plugin picker as well. When you click with the right mouse button on the plus sign, you can select synths. For instance, when I click on synths here, you can select one of the synths I have on my computer system. You can add synths as well. When you click on the plus sign with the left mouse button and go to more plugins, you see a list of all your plugins on your computer, and you can click on manage plugins. You see a complete list. I'm searching for a particular plugin, Tall Uno, it's this one, and when I double click on this one, I can mark it as favorite. It says it's a synth, and the category is synth. I'm gonna change this. I made my own category synth, and when I type in this, click on apply changes, it should be available. I close this window, right mouse button on the plus sign, I close to synth, and now it's available here, Tall Uno LX V2 plugin. It doesn't show a thumbnail, and that's a problem once in a while. I don't know if that's the problem of my version of FL Studio, FL Studio 20, but you can solve this as well. When you go to the browser window on the left side of FL Studio and you click on this icon here, you can go to the plugin database, the plugin database, and I'll select installed effects. You have a list down here, VSTs, all your plugins. I'm gonna search the right one, generators, and here it says synths. Here are my plugins, and the Tall Uno plugin is there as well. Somehow something went wrong when creating the thumbnail, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click with the right mouse button on this one and I'm gonna delete this file. Don't worry, you're not deleting the complete plugin, only the mention in this folder. So I'm gonna click this one. Yes, I want to delete the Tall Uno, and in this case I'm gonna edit once again manually. Click on the plus sign with the left mouse button, more plugins, and I'm gonna open the plugin actually. So the Tall Uno plugin, that's the one. When I click on this arrow key, and that's the correct order, I can add to plugin database. When I click on this, Tall Uno will be added to the subcategory synths, and that's exactly what I want. So when I click on OK, confirm, the Tall Uno is added, and right now I can drag and drop the plugin to a separate channel if I want to. Still, when I click with the right mouse button and click to synth, the Tall Uno plugin is here as well, this time with a thumbnail. So there are several ways to add plugins to FL Studio. The plugin picker works fine. I personally prefer the browser window. You can make you can add plugins for effects as well, delay, reverb. I have a couple of plugins, dynamics, and you can all add them by, well, just the same way. Click on the arrow, flag as favorite, add to plugin database, flag as favorite, and this way the plugin will be added to the folder that's selected. It will make things a little bit more organized in FL Studio, and it makes it more easy to find your favorite plugins and to insert them on your tracks and projects. So give it a try, organizing plugins in FL Studio.